Hello students, today we are going to start with the second part of the water resources, that is of course irrigation. Now what is actually irrigation? Very simply, if you have to define irrigation, it is the use of artificial means of water for agriculture. Whenever instead of natural rainfall, other forms of water is used for agriculture, then it can be termed as irrigation. Artificial use of artificial means of water can be termed as irrigation. Simple word mein Hindi mein sichai. Now, why irrigation is required? Especially in India, in a country like India, irrigation is very much a necessity. Why we need the irrigation? There are number of reasons why we need the irrigation. The first reason is of course dependence on monsoons. We find that India actually is an agricultural country, and agriculture is in India totally dependent on the monsoons. If the monsoons come in time, then adequate amount of rainfall is there, it results in bumper crop production. But if the rainfall is delayed, if it is does not come in time, then it can be fulfilled only with the help of irrigation. Second thing is uncertainty of the rain or uncertain rains. As I was telling you, rains in our country is mostly by the monsoons. But there is uncertainty in terms of arrival, and also we find in the distribution also. Distribution, that is all parts of the country do not get equal amount of rainfall. There are certain areas which during the monsoon season, like if you take the case of western part of the Western Ghats, northeastern part of the country, they get very heavy amount of rainfall. But other parts of the country, they get moderate to very low amount of rainfall. So in such areas, we need the irrigation. And also, uneven distribution of rainfall is of course there. Now, another thing why we need the irrigation is for cultivation, particularly on the hill slopes. Hill slopes, if it is a windward side, of course, it gets plenty of rain. But the hill slopes, the water cannot stay there, it percolates down. So for cultivation of crops on the hill slopes, we need the irrigational facilities. Then apart from it, the nature of soil. If we look at the soil types in our country, certain soil types, of course alluvial soil is there, black soil is there, they have high moisture content. They do not require much amount of water. But there are also soils like sandy soil is there, red soil is there, laterite soil is there, which cover vast areas of our country. So cultivation of crop in such type of soil can be done only with the help of irrigation only. Then another reason is crop requirements. Now crop requirements, there are actually certain type of crops, like for example, there is rice, there is jute, there is sugarcane. These are the crops, though they are grown during the summer months when the rainfall is there, but still these crops require more amount of water. They require huge quantities of water, and it can come only with the help of irrigation only. Then apart from it, since the Green Revolution has been a success in our country in the 1960s, from the 1960s onwards, we have been using high yielding variety seeds or HYV seeds along with chemical fertilizers. Whenever these seeds and fertilizers are used, it needs to be supplemented with right amount of water, and it can be supplied only with the help of irrigation only. Another reason why we need irrigation is the growing population of the country. Population, all of you know, is growing at an alarming rate. We are, all of you know that we are the second most populated country of the world. And for meeting the food requirement of the population, we need to improve our agriculture. 2 to 3 crops need to be grown, and it can be done only with the help of irrigation. Talking about the 2 to 3 crops, all of you, I think, should know. In any case, we'll be discussing in the chapter agriculture later on. In India, the cropping seasons are what we call kharif crops, rabi crops, and in between these two, there is one crop, what we call jaid crops. Kharif are the summer crops which are normally grown during the monsoon, of course with the monsoon rainfall. But for growing rabi and jaid crops, rabi crops do of course are grown during the winter months, when except the northern part of the country, especially Punjab, Haryana and western Uttar Pradesh and also Tamil Nadu regions, they get winter rainfall. But cultivation of crops in the rest of the country during rabi season is done with the help of irrigation. Jaid, of course, is a summer crop which is grown just after the harvesting of rabi and before the onset of the rains, and it is mostly done with the help of irrigation only. Apart from that, we need to maximize our crop production, which can be done again with the help of irrigation. And it has already found that whenever irrigation is used, it always results in high yield of the crops. Now coming to the next segment, that is methods of irrigation. When you talk of the methods of irrigation, normally irrigation is done in India either by wells or tube wells or canals or tanks. A little bit about each one of them. Let's start with the wells. Wells basically is a very simple digging of the earth surface, and normally 10 to 15 feet is dug and water is drawn out. Number of methods are there. Sometimes it is done with the Persian wheel. It can be done by the simple lever, or even simple bucket is also used for drawing out the water. In fact, I have mentioned in with photographs in the slides, you can see various methods of drawing out the water from the well. Now, this type of irrigation is actually more common, or you can say more popular, in the northern part of our country, especially Uttar Pradesh is there, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Punjab is there, and even West Bengal. In these areas, this type of irrigation is more common. Now, this type of irrigation, wells, almost in our country, you would find almost 25% of the country's irrigation is done by the wells. Actually, in case of the tube wells, roughly 23% of the irrigation, almost 45% of the irrigation, and 7% of the irrigation is done by this. Now, coming back to the wells, wells of course has certain advantages as well as disadvantages also. Advantage of the wells, of course, they are compared to the other forms of irrigation, they are comparatively much more cheaper. Water can be drawn out very easily with the help of hands only, bare hands, water can be drawn out. Then also, well, the water of the well can be used for other purposes also, like it can be used for drinking, it can be used for bathing, and other household requirements it can be used. Well can be set up within the agricultural fields also. It requires very low amount of space, and if the water table is high, then of course water, just by digging a few feet, water can be drawn out. But wells of course have its disadvantages also. Among the disadvantage, first, water cannot be drawn out continuously for long period of time. Continuously bahut der tak pani nikal nahi sakte. If you continue to draw out the water for long period of time, the well may get empty. Pura khali ho sakta hai. Of course, within 3-4 hours, it may again get filled up, but you cannot draw out water continuously. Another disadvantage, water cannot be transported for long distances with the help of wells. It cannot be transported long distance. Pani ko bahut dur tak nahi le jaya ja sakta. Another disadvantage of the wells, normally during the summer months, they can dry up. जब पानी का जरूरत होता है तब हो सकता है वो कोई काम का ना है. Also, wells are of no use if the ground water level, मतलब जमीन के नीचे जो पानी अवेलेबल होता है, if it is water table is lower, the cost of construction will be very much higher in case of wells. Coming to the tube wells, it is basically a pipe which is inserted into the ground. And normally up to 600 feet, it is normally inserted. And water is directly taken out from the water table. In case of the wells, water which is available below the surface of the water actually seeps down to this well and fills it up. But here, the tube wells, the pipe is inserted directly up to the water table. And with the help of hand pumps, with the help of motors, water is actually drawn out. Now, again, this form of irrigation is more common in the northern part of the country, Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Assam. In this case, in these states, they are much more popular. Now, in the southern part of the country, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu are some of the states where this form of irrigation is popular. Now, tube wells can be of two types. Either they can be shallow tube wells or it can be deep tube wells. Now, it also has certain advantages, disadvantages. Coming to some advantages of the tube wells. First, it requires very low amount of space, very little space is required for drawing out the water. Second, it can be located in the agricultural fields. Third, the water can be used for various other purposes apart from irrigation like drinking. In fact, this point, water can be used for various other purposes like drinking is applicable for all kinds of irrigation, also, all methods of irrigation. Then, tube well, water can be drawn out continuously for a long period of time. It won't get affected. That is, it won't finish. It is more suitable during the summer months when there is scarcity of water. Some disadvantage. Tube wells, construction cost is comparatively higher. Second, it needs electric supply for running the pumps, or at least generators should be there for if it is done with the help of generators. And especially in our country where the farmers are poor, it is actually a big thing. Dependence on electricity is always there. Apart from it, if the water is drawn out continuously, it can increase the saline content of the soil. Also, excessive amount of drawing of the water, it can result in depletion of the groundwater levels. Now, coming to the next one, canals. Canals actually is the most popular means of irrigation in our country, and the most popular state in this form of irrigation is Punjab, where almost 77% of the agricultural land area is under irrigation. Now, canals are actually channels of water which are connected either with the rivers, directly with the rivers, or reservoirs of dams, or it can be reservoirs of the barrages through which water is supplied with the help of channels and diverted to the agricultural fields. Two types of canals are there. One is inundation canals and another one is perennial canal. Inundation canals have water in them mostly during the rainy season, where when the river is in flood, they do not have water in them throughout the year. Perennial canals are the ones which are normally connected with the reservoirs of dams, and they have supply of water in them throughout the year. Some advantages of the canals: water is directly supplied to the agricultural fields. Second, it is much more cheaper, particularly for the farmers. Also, canals can be used for navigational purposes also. Also, the canals can be used for rearing of fishes. Disadvantage: sometimes it can lead to water logging of the fields. Also, fine sediments of the soil can be washed away along with the flow of the water, as there is continuous supply of water. Also, whenever canal irrigation is done, the cost of construction is definitely on the very higher side. Also, another disadvantage, the depth of the canals can decrease over a period of time due to siltation. Mitti jama hone ke karan gehrai kam ho sakta hai. Coming to the tanks. Tanks are natural or artificial hollows of land in which the natural rainwater is actually stored. This water is drawn out either with the help of pumps or it can be done manually. This form of irrigation is more popular in the southern part of our country, where number of tanks are present, mainly because of the fact that rivers there are non-perennial in nature. Advantages, disadvantage. First, the advantage of the tanks. The tanks actually prevent the wastage of natural runoff water, which during the rainfall gets accumulated in the tanks, which otherwise would have been wasted. Another advantage of the tanks is the water can be used for various other purposes. The tanks also are used, especially if it is handmade tanks, water can be used directly in the agricultural fields also. Disadvantage much more compared to the advantage. Bahut jyada hi disadvantage hai. Excessive land area is required. Bahut jyada jitna bada hai, it requires more amount of land. If more amount of water needs to be stored, more amount of land is used, which otherwise could have been used for agricultural purposes. There is evaporation of water as a result of the tanks may not be of any use during the summer months. Loss of water, ek to evaporation ki wajah se hota hai, and also due to the seepage, that is water goes down below. For these two reasons, there is water in the tanks goes down very quickly. Also, cost of construction definitely is on the higher side. Another disadvantage of the tanks, if the area nearby the tanks are not kept clean, then of course it can result in the growth of various kinds of diseases. And also another disadvantage of the tanks is that the tanks, as a result of siltation, their depth goes down. Now, overall, whatever may be the reasons, irrigation is of course very much important in India. There are advantages if we have to take of the irrigation, there are a number of them. First advantage of irrigation, increase in the food production is there. It modifies soil quality. It raises, lessens the risk of damage by drought. Then increase the income of the farmer and of course bring cash to them. Then of course, it also provides employment to the labor. It also improves the standard of living, also increases the value of the land. Then of course, results in national security and self-sufficiency. National security in terms of food security. Like for example, India, being an agricultural country, it has vast reserves of food. That is why it is now being, abhi agar dekhoge, the time which we are spending, the government is distributing huge amount of food from its stocks. It has been possible mainly because food stocks have been built up over a period of time. So it helps in the national security as well as self-sufficiency. Also, as a result of the irrigation, particularly it can help in navigation through the canals, of course. Then it also improves the domestic and industrial water supply, improves of course the groundwater storage, and of course in certain kind of as a result of irrigation, dams have been constructed which are used for hydropower generation. Disadvantages of course are there. It can result in water logging. It can result in water logging. Salinity of the soil can increase if excessive amount of irrigation is done. Then soil, it can result in soil erosion, that is air content in the soil can increase, thereby affecting the quality of the soil. It can result in pollution of underground water. And whenever it is irrigation facilities are used, it always results in colder and damper conditions, which can result in growth of diseases, particularly malaria. Then, next thing, a little bit about groundwater. Groundwater, as I had mentioned before also, it is the water which is found below the surface of the earth. Water is available. Har jagah pe pani available hai jameen ke niche. Only difference is that in some places the water table is very high, in some places it is very low. In places like West Bengal, if you dig just 1 meter to 2 meter, you can strike the groundwater. But if you go to Rajasthan, wahan pe jaake khodna shuru karoge, you need to dig almost, it can be 10 to 20 meters, then maybe you can get to the water. Now, excessive use of groundwater, particularly for irrigation, has resulted in the lowering of the water table. Continuous use of groundwater, not only for irrigation, but also in urban areas, such water is used excessively, as a result of which water table has gone down. It also has reduced the surface. Whenever the groundwater level goes down, the surface waters that is there in the rivers, in the lakes, in the tanks, ponds, they also undergo changes. It can also result in land subsidence, like water below the surface of the earth, it is supporting the land that is above. Whenever the water goes down, there actually creates a vacuum between the water and the soil. It can result, if the gap increases, entire land can subside. Pura ka pura jameen dhas sakta hai. Then, quality of groundwater over a period of time deteriorates, because as the gap increases, the soil which is was supported by the water, it may fall into the water and it may affect the quality of the water. Now, this video actually has almost touching 25 minutes, so I will stop here. Multipurpose River Valley project I will be discussing in the next video.